Welcome, welcome, welcome. You listen to KHTS 1220 and 98.1 FM, the Ask Brien Show, every Thursday, 1 to 2 p.m. That's the only thing you should be doing, 1 to 2 p.m. every Thursday, listening to the Ask Brien radio show and learning about business. All right, so for those of you who have not listened to the show, I think almost everybody has, but there are a few that haven't, so we want to quickly go over some ground rules, okay? And by the way, Patrick knows, like no other station in the world!
Right, oh, I was not ready for that. I'm so used to not.
Yeah, well, because I had to get you going.
Oh, and I have a headache. Hi, everybody.
You're going to have even a bigger headache now.
Sorry you have a headache, Patty. This is not the right place for you to be.
Yep. Don't worry, drinking plenty of agua.
Too sensitive. All right, so.
Jeez.
Let's go. So every week we try to have a show that teaches something about business. And each week somebody asks us, why is Ask Brien spelled with an E? My name is not Brien. My name is Peter. Brien is with an E. Most people spell it with an A or Y-A-N or I-A-N, but nobody spells it with an E-N except for, as we all know, come on.
What?
The Irish pub. Okay.
Okay,
the
fair.
The Irish person spells the name Brien with an E, but most people do not. And we're not the O'Brien, Ask O'Brien show. We're the Ask Brien show without the O. Although we do have a little Irish in us because Patrick is from Ireland.
I mean, my ancestors, but I was born
maybe
they came up born and raised out here.
In the potato famine, maybe?
I don't know. I don't know.
Traci,
help me.
Pub and O'Brien and just get to the crux of the matter, the essence.
Well, the advertisers come in for this part of the show, so.
I mean, you would think that O'Brien's Pub somewhere in the USA or Ireland or in the world was sponsoring this show. They get so much publicity.
Yeah, seriously. Just the random O'Brien's Pub.
Who's to say they aren't?
Well,
Have you checked it out? All right.
Fair enough.
So, Mr. Patrick, give us some reasons. You have a drum roll? All right. Good job. All right.
Gone? Did you guys get that?
Oh,
we changed the whole
fancy toy.
We changed the whole show around. We did what Traci loves: pivot.
I'm having too much fun too over here. Anyways,
I'm really starting to think that O'Brien Pub does sponsor this show. Fancy toy.
Oh, God.
Anyway, why do we spell Brien with an E?
Anyways, so there's a number of E's that have to do with the theme of Ask Brien. One of them was, well, certainly after right now, we bring a lot of enthusiasm and...
No empathy.
No, I was cueing you for your, you know, the alley-oop slam dunk with the excitement, but you're not getting either now. So.
Oh, whoa.
I already said it. He was not being empathetic right there, folks. Boom, that is three.
I said it, though. I said no empathy.
He did, but he wasn't showing empathy to me.
Well, I'm not exactly... That's not my job.
I hope you weren't holding your breath for that, Pat.
If he did, he'd be turning blue.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah,
that is,
already,
to be fair, Traci, that's...
He would be escaped.
Actually, you know...
I would have been dead years
he's
ago.
He's wearing a red shirt. And if he turned blue, it'd be very patriotic for our July 4th.
That is fair. Oh man.
That is so unfair.
Let's see. We had the enthusiasm, the excitement, the empathy. Education is a main one, probably the most
no
important one.
No clapping for that or whatever.
You know what? Hold
we
on.
We should have a clapping. I mean, this is what we do.
Golf clap.
Education.
Golf clap.
Education.
Golf
we try
clap.
To educate people.
Yeah, we try to educate.
Well, we're
going to
get a lot of education on with our guest today, which I'm pretty psyched about.
Indeed. I know that
because he is an expert.
Ah, an expert's
oh,
a big one too.
You're trying to take away his ease. I got you.
No,
okay,
no, no.
Yeah,
she's
yeah.
fine. She can chime in. I can. Traci can.
Chiming's not with an E.
I am encouraging him.
Hey, that's another E, by the way. And also, his engineer is also here, and that would be me.
And where is the engineer, Emily?
Engineer Emily is, as you would like to put, off on assignment.
Did it.
Yes. She'll be back next week.
Like Les Nessman from WKRP.
Yes. And then wasn't there... Oh, we are forgetting one. And you know what? This one is... I know this one's your personal favorite one, Trace. So why don't you bring us in with your favorite, E?
Well, I'm going to start it off, though. Grease Lightning...
is electrifying.
I gave you the softball.
Electrifying.
It just never gets old. I love it so much.
I know.
It's like my favorite word to say. Electrifying.
And then Danny Zuko falls over. It's so overdramatic, but it's so good.
I'm channeling my Olivia Newton-John.
Sandy!
Yeah, well, I'm thinking about the Broadway play before it started. All right.
Am I forgetting? Are we good? Did we get everything?
Are you an expert or not?
We already said expert. Traci had that.
And what do you need to do to become an expert?
You need experience, and that's 10,000 hours.
And how do you get 10,000 hours?
I'm never going to get the quadratic formula on that correct.
The quadratic formula? Can you, like, multiply?
Yeah, but I need a calculator.
How many hours a week do you normally work?
Well, me personally?
2, okay. I got it.
No.
4, all right. It's a big week for you.
Okay.
Most people, they call it a 40-hour work week.
40-hour work week, right.
And if you work 40 hours and you work 50 weeks a year because you get 2 weeks off for vacation, how many is that?
You lost me already.
2,000 hours.
There we go.
And if you work for 5 years,
I don't know, but I just
want to
know
10,000.
An entrepreneur that works 40 hours a week because I haven't seen a 40-hour work week in years.
Yeah, well, that's the question I have is why doesn't Patrick say the most important one is education? Why doesn't he say
I said education
hold
already.
On, hold on. But why doesn't he use the word entrepreneur?
Entrepreneur. I think
why
that's,
not?
Well, I think that's one of our newer ones.
Oh, I think it's definitely ahead of the others.
I think so. You were literally saying weeks ago education's the most number one, so I have that ingrained in my
yes,
head.
Yes, but as Traci has taught us, we pivot.
Like Ross Geller. Right.
Like right now we're gonna pivot and Tracy's gonna start the interview.
Pivot.
Go ahead, Trace.
Oh my gosh, are you serious?
I'm pivoting.
So honored.
I'm
and
pivoting.
A little scared. Okay. Does that mean I get to introduce our expert guest who is exceptional in everything that she endeavors?
As long as we're not talking about you, sure.
Oh, that wasn't very kind.
That wasn't nice. I'm on your side, Traci.
Thanks, Patty. Now I feel very sad, but not really. Okay. Because you know why? Because we got Wonder Woman twins unite on this show today. I want to bring on Jenn Trebeck, who is epic, by the way, another new E that we can have. Jenn is a health and nutrition expert. She is a very successful entrepreneur. She is also a podcast host of the Salad with a Side of Fries podcast, best name ever, and was voted 40 under 40, one of the 40 under 40 of podcast magazines as a successful podcaster. And we are very lucky to have her as our guest today. Welcome, Jenn.
Hi, guys. I was trying to think of a word that would started with an E that meant like honored, and I flopped.
Well, how about ecstatic? We'll go with that.
It could be ecstatic. Hold on. You could say, how about elite?
Enlightened.
Elite is also top of the line.
Well, we could also talk about literally eating because that's one of the things that Jenn
I do that very well. I'm really an expert at that. An expert in eating.
Me too. Yeah. So, Jenn, tell us, let's start out by you sharing with us your entrepreneurial journey. What got you to where you are today? How did you start on this path?
And how did you get on the show?
All right, so we're going to... Okay. How did you get on this radio show?
Totally. How did I end up in your ear, everybody? Wouldn't you like to know? So it's funny. I went to business school in undergrad, and they teach you to be an awesome employee, another E word. And then I graduated. I started working, and now I also come from parents who work for themselves. So I start working, and I'm like, ooh, I'm bored. And so I was looking for things. And there were a couple people on the team that I was working on at the time, I worked at an ad agency that specialized in catalogs. And there's two people who were on my team who were only a couple levels sort of above me in the organization, but they were like 10 to 15 years older than I was. And I remember calling my parents and saying, if it is 10 years from now and I am still here at this company doing the job that's like one or two levels above where I am now, like put me on a plane, fly me home to Michigan. Like, we're going to call this New York thing a done deal, you know? And in that process, right? So I was like, okay, I need something else. This definitely can't be my life forever. And then we were planning an annual family vacation for December. And I had to go into the computer system to request the time off. And it hit me like an anvil that I was requesting permission for access to my own time. And so I was like, okay, I don't know what I'm going to do, right?
I mean, that I was really like, actually never heard it phrased that way. That's very powerful. You were literally asking permission to how to spend your own time.
Mm-hmm. And so I was like, in that moment, I said to myself, like, I don't know what I'm going to do. I just know that I will not work for somebody else for the rest of my life. And I went out looking for things to do on the side to potentially just make extra money and invest it. Or, you know, I didn't really know what it was going to be. Simultaneous to that, I was going through my own saga of weight management, trying every diet under the sun, gaining and losing. And then, you know, ultimately those two worlds collided because I found a program, if you will, that completely changed my life and allowed me to say that I kicked my food issues. And so I was like, everybody deserves to know this information. Like, I really called it the nutrition education we're all supposed to know and no one ever taught us. And so I was like, okay, this is going to be my thing. I'm going to build a business and do this. And so that was late 2007. I started working with clients on the side. I built my business on the side from 2007, like late 2007 to June, July 2019. Launched my podcast in August of that year. And now fast forward, I'm on the Ask Brien Show.
Well, that's a top honor, I know. But
I'm saying, I mean, you've made it, girl. You made it.
Totally.
Well, Peter, do you want to fire away your rapid-fire questions, or would you like for me to continue? Now, Peter is an attorney by trade, so strap in, because
he'll drill it. So are you ready for your course examination yet? All right. The problem with course examination is...
an attorney, so I think I'll be all right.
The problem with course examination is you're only supposed to ask questions that we have answers of yes or no. And since I don't have the background, I can't do course examination, so I have to do exploratory. Another E, exploratory. So, a couple questions I want to know. You said you started this business on the side in 2007. Uh-huh. You didn't tell us what the business is.
Yeah, so I'm a health coach. I have a specialty in weight management, and I do a lot in my practice with supplementation. But so I worked nights and weekends working with clients one-on-one and in small groups to help them look better, feel better, have more energy, and as a side effect, take up less space physically.
Well, yes, if you lose weight. All right, so the question is, all right, how do you start? All right, you're working. All right, you don't want to go back to Michigan, like every millennial who lives in the basement. How do you start a business? Just like, okay, I mean, how do you get the word out? How do you get clients? How do you do all that? I mean, it sounds like a lot of stuff you have to do. You can plan it out. You can say, I'm going to get 10,000 people, make $10 million, but it's not that. That's easier said than done. So, how do you start out?
1,000%. So, because it was on the side, I fortunately didn't have the pressure of, oh my God, I need a million people in order to make any money and pay rent, right? So there is some value in that way of starting on the side, and therefore you're not coming from a place of desperation often. And so it really started with people who noticed my progress. And people would start to ask me what I was doing or what it was. And so it was little bits, and it grew over time. So the first piece was starting with the people who were asking. And then the second piece was going to that cold market. So I think so often people try to build a business with everybody they knew before. And the thing for me was that everybody who knew me before didn't know me as somebody who knew nutrition or wellness or supplementation. So starting by networking and meeting new people, I was introducing myself, and they only knew me as somebody who knew this information and could help people with this, you know, these kinds of challenges. So networking was huge. And, you know, we could dig deeper into that, because please don't just show up to something and do the business card shuffle. Like, if networking is going to work, it's about building relationships and really getting to know people. But so networking was a big piece of it. And then over time, that typical like warm market started to then ask me questions and see me as an expert in this space. And then the podcast certainly added to that, because, you know, also the podcast came 12 years or so into working with clients. But it put the visibility on a totally different scale.
So it sounds like everything you're saying in a summarization as an attorney is basically everything you're doing to lead yourself to become an authority in the subject.
Correct.
To become the authority. Because if you're the authority, then people are going to contact you. You don't need to contact them, like through ads or other things. They know who you are.
Right.
So,
and it's, I find too, the referrals and building those relationships is so much more powerful and effective than the ads, especially in what I do. But you know, if we don't have rapport, if we don't, you know, if we're not going to vibe, it doesn't matter how much I know.
And in trying to get that vibe, how can you tell? So you go, let's not talk about, you know, networking in the traditional sense. You're just down the street and you see somebody and you start a conversation up. How long is a typical process in relationship building to get from, hey, I just sing hello, to a call to action? You know what, if you want, you know, health advice, whatever, I can help you out.
That's a great question. I wish it was a singular answer. You know, it really is different for every person, and it sort of depends how the conversation starts. I mean, there have been times, you know, years ago, I remember I was in an AT&T store, and I heard somebody talking about a recent diagnosis. And I turned around and I said, I'm so sorry. Like, I'm not, you know, I don't mean to eavesdrop, but this is what I do. Here's my card. If you have any questions or need anything, you know, take it, leave it, but here you go.
And how long?
P.S. Yeah, that person never called.
Never called. I'm sorry I didn't call you back.
All right. Yeah. But there's, you know, when it happens, where maybe it's more of, okay, here's a different scenario. I was at a friend's Super Bowl party last year, and so it was still somewhat odd COVID times, and so it was a smaller group, and there was a commercial or something. I started yelling at the TV because I was like, you can't say that, you know, or whatever it was. I can't remember. And somebody said, wait, what? And I was like, oh, well, you know, this is what I do or whatever. And she said, oh, wait, can I have your card? And so she ended up turning into a client. And so sometimes it's just the context. It's being a human. It's, you know, is there something we have in common? Is whether that's, you know, some sort of activity or the place that we're in where we're meeting each other, or a lot of times, especially when it's somebody's referred to me by somebody else, so the first time I'm meeting them is even in this context, and it's a lot of times we'll bond to some degree over all the diets that we've tried over the years, you know, and it's like, oh, I did this one. Did you do that one? You know, what happened when you tried this? You know, and sort of that shared history really helps to see, you know, if we're a fit.
Well, thank you very much. We're going to be taking a break. You're listening to KHTS 1220, 98.1 FM. When we return, Jen is going to tell us how effective it is for an entrepreneur to be fit.
Do you remember Bill O'Reilly? He was a talk show host on Fox News. What would he say now about the latest from the Biden administration? We're happy to tell you Bill O'Reilly has joined KHTS Radio for No Spin News. He cuts through the spin and gives you a fair, smart, fact-based analysis. It's your dose of common sense for Santa Clarita. Hear about the latest craziness from Washington. Join Bill O'Reilly every Monday through Friday from 6 to 7 p.m.
It's the No Spin News on KHTS 98.1 FM and AM 1220.
Your business sign is essential to getting customers to your location. Feathers can help you get your business noticed. Feathers, now in a new larger space with plenty of parking. They walk you through each phase of your project with special attention to detail and quality. Feathers will provide you a sign that you can be proud of. Your sign will draw customers in instead of having them drive by. Visit Feathers online at feathersigns.com or go to Feathers' brand new bigger location at 26017 Huntington Drive off Rye Canyon or call 298-9442.
MB2 Raceway, fast high-performance kart racing at LA County's only indoor electric kart racing facility, and you're the superstar driver. Motocross legend and DEI driver Ricky Carmichael and Team Andretti Green's Brian Herta race in MB2 when they're not fighting it out for world championships, and so can you. MB2 Raceway, located between San Fernando and Santa Clarita Valleys, where the 5, the 210, and the 14 freeways meet in Sylmar. It's MB2 Raceway. Dial 1-866-986-RACE. That's 1-866-986-RACE. MB2 Raceway, where racers race.
I'm Richard Sherman of Radius Agent, formerly of Alta Realty. I've been helping people buy and sell and save their homes in Santa Clarita for over 30 years. I also offer help with free foreclosure defense. I offer help with money to buy your home, and I'll even offer you money to help you sell your home. If you feel you're in danger of losing your home to foreclosure, don't wait. Banks will still go through with foreclosure even during the pandemic. I can save your home for free. We really do it completely for free. If you need help buying, selling, or defending your home, or if you're dealing with a foreclosure, I'm here to help. Call me, Rich Sherman, 714-1400. That's 661-714-1400.
Santa Clarita Valley residents now have greater access to the excellent physicians and high-quality medical services for which Providence Holy Cross is known. Providence Holy Cross Health Center in Santa Clarita features state-of-the-art cancer and imaging technologies, as well as board-certified physicians in a variety of medical specialties. Quality and compassion from a healthcare provider you can depend on. For more information, call 1-888-HEALING or visit us at providence.org.
Hometown, your hometown station.
Welcome back. You're listening to KHTS 1220 and 98.1 FM, the Ask Brien Radio Show. Traci, you're still there? Oh, I'm not sure where she went. Anyway, Jen, before we went to break, I had asked that question. Some of our listeners want to know, okay, that's great in how you built your business, but how important is it to be healthy, and how important is it to exercise and other things to really be a successful entrepreneur? I mean, on a scale of 1 to 10.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I think it's probably a 9.
Okay.
And here's the thing. I think if we've learned anything over the last couple of years, hopefully what we've learned is the importance of our health, right? That if we don't have that, all the other things kind of come second. So, and I think the reality for most of us as entrepreneurs is that we are our business. Even if we have team, even if we're not doing it ourselves, we are our business. And there, if we're not well, if we're not able to function, the business suffers. So we want to think about taking care of ourselves as a piece of taking care of the business. And so often we think, oh, I have to stay up to finish this thing. I have to, you know, I don't have time to move or get some activity in because I have to, you know, work on X, Y, or Z. And every time we make those trade-offs, we're actually sort of depleting the cup that allows us to give to our business. You know, the cup that pours into the business, if you will.
So in a, let's go to your situation. How often how often do you work out per week?
So I work out every day.
Every day?
Said that I do. But I'm, again,
I do it twice a day.
My commitment level is not my commitment level is not necessarily everybody else's commitment level. And the other thing is, we all have a very different perspective or, you know, idea of what that means and what that looks like. So one thing that I give everybody, especially busy entrepreneurs, is something I call 30-30-30. This takes less than 2 minutes. You don't have to change your clothes for, you know, you don't have to redo your makeup or your hair or any of the things. Brien, you don't have to do your hair.
I can't do my hair. My hairstyle is after Einstein, okay? Einstein's hairstyle is what I copied, and I have to continue to look that way, and I will continue my entire life.
All right, so here's how we do the 30-30-30.
It's charming, that.
Right. I think so. Even the owner of the radio station tells me to comb my hair before the show, but I don't listen to anyone. I'm an entrepreneur.
Well, yeah, it's radio. You said I don't really think he's... You don't really have to comb it for radio, so that it must look really bad.
So, here's the 30-30-30.
We digress.
All right.
I thought those were measurements. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Right. 30 squats. 30 crunches.
And?
30 push-ups if you can do it. Or, you know, you could do it on a wall. You could do it, you know, with a chair. You could do 30 arm circles each direction. You could stay sitting in a chair and do 30 leg lifts. And then you could do 30, like, tricep dips, all using a chair.
As
any
long,
combination of three exercises, 30 each.
As long as I get 30 hours to rest, I'll be fine.
Right. So, and what's cool about this, by the way, is that it takes less than 2 minutes. And so, you know those moments when you have two minutes before a Zoom call?
Speak for yourself.
Exactly. Patrick, how long does it take you to do that? Patrick, how long will it take you to do 30 push-ups, 30 squats, and 30 leg lifts? Can you do that in 2 minutes?
2 minutes? No.
How long is that going to take
you? Yes,
you
can. I mean, I promise you. Do 10. Do 3 sets of 10 each. I promise you, you can do it.
Oh, I could do like one of those like in the 30s. Like I could totally do that in 2 minutes, but all together in two? No. Give me at least like 10. Right. 10 I could do. 10 minutes. 10,
you
or, 10
do
minutes.
I was thinking 30 minutes to do the 30.
No,
30.
I'm fit. I'm fit, but 2 minutes, like,
wanted,
I'm not a fast one.
Okay, wait. 30. All right, so forget the one with the push-ups. If you're doing it sitting in a chair, right?
Uh-huh.
If you're sitting in a chair and you put your arms out to the side.
He's having to dumb it down for us.
Speak for yourself. Go ahead.
You know, listen. Do 30 jumping jacks instead. Do 30 jumping jacks, 30 squats.
Oh, I could do that. I could do that in 2 minutes. Easy.
I don't think you can do 30 jumping jacks. Actually, Patrick, I want you to do 30 jumping jacks right now.
I'm not doing that right now.
Come on. You got 30 seconds.
I am
working. I got the clock right there.
No.
You call that work?
Wait a minute. Turn your mic off and do it while we keep talking.
Exactly.
And we'll time it.
All right, hold on.
No, I am not.
I'm going now. All right.
All right, Peter's going
to
do it.
I have to do jumping jacks. Well, the problem is I got to...
I will provide commentary.
I have a shoulder problem.
Oh my God. Is this on Facebook Live? This is currently
on Facebook. I will be providing commentary.
I want to have you back when my shoulder's better.
Oh.
I have a shoulder problem.
Oh,
excuse.
All right, we'll do that. Okay.
Or if I can do it with one.
So here's the deal.
He's doing it with one arm. He's doing it with one arm, ladies and gentlemen. This is currently on Facebook Live. It's working.
Oh my God.
Do you see this, Traci?
I don't say I didn't make anything happen.
Well, the good thing is this is being recorded on Facebook Live, so we have proof. This is the thing.
We have evidence.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, look and see Mr. Peter Bronstein doing one-handed jumping jacks.
Done.
And he's done, ladies and gentlemen.
How many seconds?
To be fair, I wasn't counting. I was enjoying the show, not counting.
That was hovering around a minute. Well,
we got more.
Snacks the whole time.
We got a bargain. We got a whole minute of them doing it. Sweet.
Woo. Traci ate 30 chips, so you know, there's that. I ate 30 potato chips while you were doing that.
It was great. so it offsets each other. Right, right.
Right. I'm about to go into 30 M&Ms.
I'm going to take 30 sips of water right now.
I'm sorry.
No, it's all good. So,
all right.
So here's the deal, right? It's those moments when you're like, what can I do in 2 minutes before this next Zoom call? This. We have this idea that for our activity to count, it has to be 30 minutes or 45 minutes or an hour, and it has to make us feel like we're going to die. That is nonsense. If you did
well,
this a couple
make
times
feel like
a day,
you're gonna die.
Oh, I hope no. It should not. Don't do the push-up one, then, Traci. But like, you know, to me, running makes me feel like I'm going to die. I don't run. I take it back. I do my version of a run to the door when the delivery guy shows up with my food. But other than that, I don't run. So,
I only run when I'm being chased.
Right. Well, even then, I'll probably end up passing.
Can we run that back? What?
Okay, so what I'm hearing you say is, let's get this thing back on track. So what I'm hearing you say is that as entrepreneurs, we're often overscheduled, overbooked, like we barely have any time in between calls, meetings, projects and everything. But if we can just slice out, let's just call it 2 to 5 minutes for those of us who are just getting started, we can get in these 30, 30, 30. Now, how many times a day do you have to do that? Do you have to do it like 3 times a day or only once a day?
Start with one. Start with one and then see what happens.
I know, but I'm kind of a
goal
setter. Like, how many times a day do you do?
So go for my workout's a little bit different. So like if I do a 30, 30, 30, it's probably once in a day. I have some clients who do it 3 or 4 times a day, depending on what's happening. You know, by the way, originally this was used like in the context of like when we watch TV with commercials. So we used to talk about doing this at the commercial break. So if you think about watching an hour show, maybe there were 5 commercial breaks. So you did it 5 times. Cool. But again, sort of going back to that thing of like, do it once. Once is better than not. You know, and we can do, our body actually responds really well to a little bit of movement more frequently because, I mean, think about it, right? Like caveman life, humans were active sunrise to sunset. We weren't meant to sit at a computer all day. It's also not human to sit at a computer all day except for 1 hour when we go berserk. Like, neither side of that is human. So if we find a few times a day to get up and move around, it's much better for us in the long run than the idea that if we can't do a full, you know, hardcore 30, 45, 60 minutes, then we do nothing.
And is that the optimum workout, 3 minutes?
So if somebody says to me, like, what the objective is to move at least 30 minutes a day, most days of the week. A few times a week, we want to get our heart rate up and use our heart as a muscle. A few times a week, we want to focus on some resistance training to build muscle because muscle dictates metabolism. And muscle is also the kind of thing where, like, if you don't use it, you'll lose it. So even if we just want to maintain, we've got to do the thing. So pick up heavy things and put them back down. And pick up heavy things and put them back down. That works. Could be your
kid. That doesn't include 12 ounces. Peter, that's not 12 ounces, just so you know.
A beer? What? No,
right. Right. Listen, I will say that I have done workouts with wine bottles when traveling, and it's actually extra hard because you just don't want to break them, you know, because you don't want to end up with red wine everywhere. So, you know,
or waste.
You do what you got to do. Right, that too.
So I'm going to ask you.
Well, I
want to ask you a question. What is the best diet?
Okay, so you go first. You go first, Pete.
I want to ask, what is the best diet? You've got Atkins, keto, Mediterranean, South Beach. I mean, I've heard them all.
Yeah, I've done them all. The best diet, first of all, depends on your objective, right?
Okay.
But the best diet is actually not a diet. I know that was like the anticlimactic answer. The best diet is actually the one that you can follow for the rest of your life.
So can I
Any diet out there will work in the short term. It becomes a question of how long term is it and how healthful is it? Because most of those diets out there, we see the number on the scale go down for a little bit of time, right? Then the scale stops moving. We get frustrated. We go back to old eating habits. The number on the scale climbs back up. When we look at body composition, when the number on the scale goes down, what we're actually losing is water, muscle, and sometimes bone. Then we get frustrated, which is also why it stops after a while. We get frustrated. We go back to old eating habits. Now, remember, muscle is metabolically active. Now we have less muscle on our body to be burning that extra fuel. We add that weight back on as fat. So we lose it as water and muscle, gain it back as fat. Lose it as water and muscle, gain it back as fat. So even if you end up at the same number in the scale that you were before, by body composition, you're actually fatter. So instead
of thinking
calories
in, calories out. And that's if you don't exercise at all, though.
It doesn't matter.
And that's if you don't exercise at all.
Even exercising.
It doesn't matter?
Even exercising. No, because even exercising, you might build muscle, but your body's using that. You can't rebuild that muscle that you're trying to. The way muscle is built is that you make these, like, by working out, also, like, resistance training tears the muscle fibers. They require nutrition to rebuild. If we're not eating nutrition because we're focusing on eating less, our body can't rebuild that muscle. So working out is even just exacerbating what's happening on the scale. If we're following a lot of these typical plans of eat less, move more, or eat this very restrictive approach and move more. So instead, I want everybody to remember this instead. Quality in, quality out, get up and move more. So quality is protein and fiber at every meal. And this is for your energy, for your weight, for everything. Protein and fiber. Protein is clean, lean protein. Whether you want that to be animal or plant or whatever, doesn't matter. Clean, lean protein. Fiber is vegetables and sometimes fruit. And then a couple times a day, we want to get some quality fat, like your olive oil, avocados, nuts, those kinds of things a couple times a day. Start there. And then you can add in the other thing. So you can add in your grains. So the average American, by the way, eats more grain than an Olympic athlete is recommended to eat on race day. So we want to think about grains more like a condiment than a side dish, than a main course.
Well, certainly.
I'm tired. This is exhausting.
Yeah, because you have no energy because you didn't do the jumping jacks with me.
30 minutes. Right. I ate the snacks instead. But by the way, if we're eating those foods and we are energized for a hot second and then exhausted, it's a function of our blood sugar spiking and dropping. To have energy, to be able to do all the things that we want to do as entrepreneurs, we have to fuel ourselves. To have willpower, we have to fuel ourselves.
Well, we're going to be taking a break. We'll be right back. It was in KHTS 1220, 98.1 FM.
The pandemic put a lot of things on hold. Don't let your health be one of them. Call your Facey doctor today to schedule your annual visit or go to facey.com to make an appointment. Facey Medical Group serves the Santa Clarita Valley, and we have primary care doctors and specialists here to serve you. For more information or to make an in-person or virtual appointment, go to facey.com. Facey, let us care for you today.
Helping lead the way to a greener future, all of Birtech's Santa Clarita Valley waste collection trucks run on clean-burning natural gas. Birtech takes pride in their community, and they've been serving the SCV for nearly two decades. Because at Birtech, we'll take care of it.
Coming to the Canyon, Mark Varner's American Band, The Motels, Robbie Krieger, Corey Feldman, The Smithereens, Faster Pussycat, Richie Kotzen, Stephen Piercy of Rat, Bullet Boys, LA Guns, Asia featuring John Payne, Marsha Ball, Young Dubliners, Ambrosia, The Spinners, Eric Gales, and so much more. Country nights every Thursday. The Canyon is the perfect place to host special events. Call 888-645-5006. Book yours today. The Canyon, Santa Clarita, where music meets the soul. Tickets available through access.com.
This is Bradley from Santa Clarita Grocery, the all-volunteer grocery program serving children, families, and individuals experiencing food insecurities. Since January 2020, Santa Clarita Grocery has distributed 83 tons of fresh groceries to 4,465 families in the SCV. Santa Clarita Grocery is a drive-up, drive-through service with physical distancing in place to continue serving our community. If you are in need or looking for a charity to do the most good for our community, please consider partnering with us by donating to Santa Clarita Grocery, one of the most efficient charities in the Santa Clarita Valley. A full 99 cents out of every dollar goes directly back to the community. Santa Clarita Grocery operates on a 1% overhead and is sustained through private donations. Santa Clarita Grocery is at 21176 Center Point Parkway in the Oasis Furniture parking lot. Please visit our website, santaclaritagrocery.org, or our Facebook at Santa Clarita Grocery to make a difference in our awesome town community. 661-425-7575. Be our guest and experience the difference.
If you have a business problem, if someone doesn't honor their agreement and you need an aggressive attorney with over 27 years' experience, the Law Office of Peter Bronstein has helped partners resolve disputes, franchisees resolve disputes, and other business owners who have a challenge. Let the Law Office of Peter Bronstein take your stress away. Visit lacorporateattorney.com. Don't wait too long and lose your rights. Solve your business challenge problem today.
Visit lacorporateattorney.com.
Save water and save money. SCV Water wants to help you find your fit and take advantage of conservation rebate programs that will help you save. Water your landscape more efficiently. Replace your lawn with water-wise plants. Conduct free in-home water surveys. Cover your swimming pool and more. Find the programs that fit your needs and start saving today. Visit conserve.yourscvwater.com to learn more.
That's conserve.yourscvwater.com.
It's like no other station I've ever listened to. It's great.
Your hometown station.
Welcome back. You're listening to KHTS 1220 and 98.1 FM, the Ask Brien Radio Show, live from Newhall, California. All right, Traci, you had some questions for Jen, so go ahead.
Well, Jen, you know, when we were talking during the break, you were mentioning that you're a big advocate for everything in moderation, and
Can you share a little bit more about your philosophy around that and how that impacts your coaching business and your own personal life?
Yeah. So, well, first of all, I love food. I am a foodie. I have a whole YouTube series of just me eating at restaurants and telling you guys what's great at these restaurants. but everything in moderation, even moderation, right? The whole point is we're not going to live the rest of our lives not enjoying birthday cake. So the idea that we're going to subscribe to a plan that says that's not allowed is just setting ourselves up, I think. So it's really about understanding the things that we do 80, 90% of the time, the things that we do 10 to 20% of the time, and how everything fits together, and then how we can do it so that it doesn't necessarily have the same effect on us. So I started to mention this before about the energy, right? Energy being tied to our blood sugar. So whether we are burning fat or storing fat is also tied to our blood sugar. So it doesn't mean we're not eating the breadbasket or we're not eating dessert. What it means is don't start with the breadbasket. If we start with the breadbasket, we sit down at the restaurant, we have the bread first. Even if what we ordered is steamed fish and vegetables, we're going to end up storing it as fat because we started with the breadbasket. So start with a salad, start with a vegetable soup, start with your food, and then have a little bit of the bread. The bread is processed in your body with the nutrition, and it doesn't have the same impact on us. So eat your dessert right after your meal instead of a couple hours later so you're not separately sugar bombing your body. So it's about how do we do the things so that it doesn't impact us the same way as it used to. And when we're consistent, our body's better equipped to handle those occasional blood sugar spikes and indulgences in a very different way than if it's constantly sort of up and down.
And so with entrepreneurs, we only have like 60 seconds or so to answer this question, just giving you kind of a heads up. But as an entrepreneur, you've built multiple different revenue streams. You've been very successful through podcasting, entrepreneurship, property management, online coaching. Mm-hmm. Like you do a lot of things. What is your one tip that you could give somebody to basically stay healthy and balance work and life as an entrepreneur?
I think the one tip is forget balance. The idea of balance is a myth and setting us up. I think it's about wherever we are, be there. So if we're with family, be with family. If we're tackling a project, tackle the project. And in the grand scheme of things, I think we have to think about everything as one circle instead of this Venn diagram where we're trying to struggle in that one little spot that everything overlaps. If we think about everything supporting everything, then I think it sets us up a whole lot better to mentally and physically handle everything that's coming at us.
I love that. Okay, so I know everyone after the show is going to want to get in touch with you. They're going to want to listen to Salad with a Side of Fries. Tell us how everyone can get in touch with you.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. Hope so. We did a lot. So asaladwithasideoffries.com. Anywhere you listen to podcasts, Salad with a Side of Fries is the name of the podcast. All social media, I'm at Jenn Trebeck, J-E-N-N-T-R-E-P-E-C-K.
Well, Jen, we really super appreciate that you have joined us today and you still remain of all the podcasts and all the podcasters I know in my world, you still hold the title of my most favorite podcast title, Salad with a Side of Fries, because in my mind, that's what it is all about. Order the salad and get the side of fries.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. And thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And we want to have you back. So speaking of podcasts, we would love it if you would head over to wherever you listen to your favorite podcast and not only follow and subscribe Salad with a Salad Side of Fries, but also find and follow the Ask Brien, that's B-R-I-E-N, the Ask Brien podcast. Follow it, download it on your favorite podcast platform, and we also really, really appreciate it if while you're there, you would give us a 5-star review and tell all your friends that if they want to start, grow, or continue to scale a business, that we are the ones that they need to listen to and follow, and that is the Ask Brien, B-R-I-E-N podcast on all your favorite podcast apps.
Thank you very much, Traci. Thank you very much, Jen. Ask Brien Radio Show, over and out, 1220 and 98.1.